Hello students, let us start our session with the new topic AC generator. Basically, we have understood the concept of electromagnetic induction in earlier topics. Here one of the application we are going to discuss of the electromagnetic induction, that is the AC generator. Number of applications are there. Main application is generator. Nowadays, whatever the AC generators are there, they can give the AC output in terms of 100 megavolt, right? Here, initially a method is utilized to induce an EMF or a current in a loop through a change in a loop's orientation or change in its area. We can change its position, it means theta can be changed or A can be changed. Phi, we have B A cos theta. We can change A area or the angle theta. That is one of the method to utilize to change in phi, and based on that EMF or current can be generated. So if we are changing the, if we rotate a coil in a fixed magnetic field B, the effective area of the loop is A cos theta. So that is theta between A and B. Theta is the angle between A and B. While we rotate it, theta is going to be changed, which can produce the change in the flux to generate the AC current, and that is utilized for AC generator. So we can say that basically AC generator converts a mechanical energy into electrical energy. So basic fundamental AC generator we can discuss based on the given diagram. That is, the basic elements are defined, in which a coil is mounted over the rotor shaft. The axis of the rotation of the coil is perpendicular to the strong magnetic field between N and S. The coil is mechanically rotated in the uniform magnetic field by the external means. The rotation of the coil which generates a magnetic flux through it to change. As the magnetic flux is changed, EMF is produced. That EMF is, we are getting by having the end of the coil. The end of the coil is connected with the external circuit by split rings and brushes. So when the coil is rotated with a constant speed, angular speed omega, the angle, the theta between the magnetic field B and A is varying by having theta equals to omega t. Initially theta is 0 at time t equals to 0. As a result, the effective area of the coil to the magnetic field line is changing with the time. So flux is B A cos theta, that should be B A cos omega. Now, to get a change in the flux, epsilon equals to minus d phi by dt. If we have a number of turns of the coil, then epsilon becomes minus n d phi b by dt. Phi is b a cos omega t. So it can be replaced over here. So it should be minus n b a. Area is fixed. B is fixed, number of turns of the coil is fixed. We are changing the theta between B and A. Theta is omega t, so it should be differentiated. So my equation is minus NBA d cos omega t by dt. While we differentiate cos omega t, it should be minus sine omega t into omega. So my epsilon EMF is NBA omega sine omega t. If sine omega t, it should be plus or minus 1. while sin omega t is plus 1, the maximum EMF is NBA omega. And if sin omega t is minus 1, then negative EMF is minus NBA omega. This thing can be represented graphically over here. Ultimately, maximum value is epsilon 0. We can replace with the constant. So epsilon should be epsilon 0 sin omega t. So epsilon 0 equals to NBA omega. Here we have defined for that, as you can observe in the diagram. While the plane of the armature is perpendicular to the magnetic field, it means while the coil and the magnetic field is perpendicular to each other, at that time my generated EMF is zero, right? At same way, we can say that while it is at the 90 degree, when the armature rotates through a 90 degree, the plane of the coil in parallel to the magnetic field, so we are having, that is a sine theta is sine 90, and sine 90, it means a maximum EMF is produced. Right? If sine 0, it means a 0. So sine 0 is a 0 value, so my EMF is 0. If sine theta is 90, it means sine theta is 90, sine 90 is 1, so my EMF is NBA omega. If theta is 180, then also sine 180 is 0, so my EMF is 0. If my theta is 270, it means my sine 270 is minus 1, so my epsilon EMF is minus NBA omega. And for the 360 degree, sine 360 is 0. So again, my generated EMF is 0. This is represented over here as a graphical representation. And we can say that while we change the position of the coil, while we rotate it, based on the generated angle between B and A, it gives the angle theta. By changing the theta value, it generates a different value of EMF. So here we have noted a maximum in the minimum points plus epsilon and minus epsilon, but by connecting it with the different angles, by having joining the each point, we can get an alternate EMF, AC EMF. And based on that, AC current is generated. So we can say that mechanically rotated shaft gives you the AC current. That is the AC generator. So here, that generated AC current, whose frequency is defined as omega, it is nothing but we can define as a 2 pi V. V is the frequency, or 2 pi F. So omega equals to omega 0 2 pi V T. Here, epsilon gives you the instantaneous value of EMF. Basically, it is maximum values are there, epsilon 0 and minus epsilon 0, but at each time we can get instantaneous value of it. Commercially, whatever the shaft it is rotated is with the different sources, if that shaft is rotated by water falling from a height, so based on the water falling of the shaft over the shaft with the high speed from the dams, so that AC generator is known as hydroelectric generator. Instead of the water, if we are giving the heat to the water, which generates the steam using a coal or other sources, so that steam gives you the very high pressure over the shaft, and rotation of the shaft is possible. This technique is known as a thermal generators. instead of the coal, we also can use a nuclear fuel. So that generator is known as a nuclear power generators. So number of ways we can utilize to rotate a shaft to get a mechanical energy. In modern days, this generator can produce up to a 500 megawatt of the power. So we can say that one can light up 5 million 100 watt bulbs. In most generators, coils are held stationary. Nowadays, we are keeping a coil stationary, and it is the electromagnets that we can rotate. Another way, in this topic, whatever we have discussed is coil is rotated within the fixed magnets. Now, we also do that, keep the coil fixed and rotate a electromagnets. The frequency of the rotation of the electromagnets is provided with the 50 Hertz in India. In other countries, the different frequencies are there. In USA, that is a 60 Hertz. And that's why whatever the appliances we are purchasing from out of the India, so there should be a different converter is required to match a frequency, because their appliances are there based on their supply, 60 Hertz. And in India, we have a 230 volt 50 Hertz. So this conversion is required to operate it over here, and that's why extra adapter is required. Let us go through the example of it. Kamala pedals a stationary bicycle. The pedals of the bicycle are attached to a 100-ton coil of area 0.1 meter square. The coil rotates at half a revolution per second, and it is placed in a uniform magnetic field of 0.01 Tesla perpendicular to the axis of rotation of the coil. What is the maximum voltage generated in the coil? See, coil is rotated with the half revolution per second. It means frequency is 0.5 Hertz. Number of turns are given 100. Area is given 0.1 meter square. And magnetic field is given 0.01 Tesla. So, generated EMF epsilon 0. Here the angle is given perpendicular. It means sine theta is 90, sine theta is 1. It means maximum voltage can be generated. So that is NBA omega. Omega can be replaced with 2 pi V. V is the frequency, F means 2 pi F, 0.5 Hertz. Replace NBA and F, 2 pi F. So maximum generated EMF or the voltage is 0.314 volt. Here we are going to end our session. With that, we are going to end this chapter. Hope you understood the whole chapter thoroughly. Thank you.